Hey guys, for we here. Happy Thanksgiving. I just wanted to do a video just because it's Thanksgiving. I want to say Happy Thanksgiving. That's pretty much the only reason this Felco video is happening now. I mean, I had this Felco video in the back. Whoa, oh god, this Dr. Mario's smoothing on me. But I got smooth too, like that. A pro to neutral air. Oh god, I almost did not make that. Luckily though, Dr. Mario's got a pretty lousy recovery, so if you can gimp him, he's pretty much dead. Ow! Side B, down air connection, that was amazing, Doc. Oh yeah, this is a defeatable episode, by the way. I guess you should put Felco Thanksgiving or something, I don't freaking know. Oh god. Whatever, save those jumps. Save that up, B. You really should try to come after me. If you're fighting against the Felco or a Fox, their up B is really predictable to hit. Is he dead? He might be dead. Yep, he can't make that back. I don't think he had a jump. What song is this? I never check what... Oh, God! I never check what songs are playing whenever I'm on small battlefields, because I really don't use the stage a lot. Maybe I should do a small battlefield, like, collection one day when I'm bored. I usually just pick Cloudless Station. It just seems like it's the best pick for me. I'm a guy who gets in your face, so if you're gonna use platforms, I'm a little in trouble. Get out of here! Oh yeah, I should probably mention this. I'm gonna be going back to post-commentary defeatables. Ooh! Because... is it getting a little pricey on my bills? Like, I don't want to be using my AC, but I use my AC when I do live commentary. So, yeah, we're going back to... oh, he got scared. Post-commentary. I mean, it's not all bad. The only thing is you won't get to see me go like... whenever I get, like, something real cool live. You're just gonna see me go like... when I get, like, stuff cool recorded, like, a good couple of weeks ago. Or days. This was recorded, like, I think 5 days ago? Wait, is he? Oh, he's already on his last dog. I just now came to the fact that, yeah, I'm winning. I'm surprised. My past Felcos were, like, kind of hit or miss. Like, sometimes I would be good, sometimes I'd be bad. Oh, that was a bad decision by me. I should have went for the platform. I'm not scared, though. He's at, like, 94. And I'm, like, fresh out of the bubble thing. Like there. He can be dead right now. Yep, he's dead. He used his air dodge and his jump. He's dead. Well, that was a pretty nice first game. Alright, round two of the dock, I guess. Get him there. Oh, wow, I didn't jump that high. Weird. Remember, pros are your best friend as Felco. Well, actually, aerials are more your best friend. Felco has lots of good aerials. Is that neutral air? It hits so many times that, like, you can just, like, throw people off. Like, they air dodge, neutral air. Yeah, they do a bad air dodge, you forward smash. Look at that! Neutral air, up tilt, neutral air. Like, he's great. I guess I'm really gushing over Felco because Felco's one of my favorite Star Fox characters. Like, I've only played one Star Fox game, and it was Star Fox 64! Oh, he got killed right there. I don't know why, but, like, I've never bothered to... Ball! Oh, it was keeping me right there. No. Oh, wow! I could have, like, ripped another Forge Match there. But, like, Star Fox 64 has always been... the only game I ever played. Like, I never played Adventure, I never played Assault. I mean, I should play, assault, because I hear it's basically Star Fox, but they, you know, improved in aspects. Uh-oh. Yep, that's another stock. Again, I'm not worried. I got three stocks. I don't think I'm gonna free thought this guy, but like, just, ooh. Get some up airs in there. Ooh, and a smash. That almost killed me. Ah, that definitely killed me. Should have air dodged. But yeah. Oh, trying to get the stomp on me, are you? I love doing that reflector, but like, as I was saying, like, I've only played, like, Star Fox 64. I haven't even played the Star Fox Zero. Oh, God. Okay, where are my controls? Game, he's bringing it back. He's bringing it back. Whoa. What's all these rolls? Did I get dumb all of a sudden? Okay, he's off me. There we go. Went low, but then went high. He's dead. Ugh, I'll take this conversation, like, in the next fight.
Had enough already?
Oh, we got Inkling now. Okay. So, yeah. Here's my history of Star Fox. Pretty much, when I got a Wii, I saw this cool game. Now, I'm obsessed with birds, so when I saw Falco, I was like, hey, what's this game? And I really liked it. And then I played some Star Fox, and I was a little upset that you can't play as Falco. You can play as Falco in multiplayer, but for majority of Star Foxes, you're pretty much just Fox. Fox in the R-Wing. Fox in the Landmaster. Fox in the submarine. Fox riding a ship. That's pretty much, like, Star Fox's whole career. Also, the riding the ship part is Star Fox Salt, because there are sections where Fox would just be shooting with a gun, blaster, whatever, on someone's ship. Like, I don't want to give spoilers, but that's a thing that happens in a good, like, three times of the game. Or twice. It's been a while since I've seen an Assault playthrough. Point is, though, is Falco made me like Star Fox, and then it kind of just got me to like planes, because, like, I don't know, like, I always think of myself wearing an aviary outfit, flying a plane. So thanks, Falco, for giving me my love of planes. That said, though, I haven't played Assault, or Zero, or Command, or Adventures. Now, I hear Avengers was bad, so I shouldn't play it. Oh, I gave them the old one too. Like, down air and up smash? Sheesh. But like, he's recovering very safe. He's always going towards the ledge. Remember, always do that as Inkling. I mean, you can jump on the stage. Luckily, Inklings have this cool thing where if you land as them, they do a little splashback. But my point is, though, is that I've never really played those games, because I heard Adventure was bad, and then I heard Adventure was bad, and I can't get Assault, because Assault's for the GameCube, and Assault was pretty much like a, oh, hope you owned a GameCube at the time, because now you can't buy it, because Nintendo doesn't like to give you their old content. Whoa! Nope, still alive. That's why you saved your jump, people. Even if I didn't have a jump, I could have side beat up B. Oh no! That's dead. But to be fair, I was at like, what? 182? That's definitely worth to die. I have like so much damage on this guy. Oh, you're back here? Fine. But like, I just couldn't really get other Star Fox games, because Assault was too much, and I heard Adventure was bad. So now I wanna buy Assault. I gotta spend like way more than it's worth. Like, who wants to spend like 100 something on Assault? I don't. Got him. Aw. That's definitely a clippable moment, but like, yeah. And then we have Zero. And Zero, to me, looks like it's Star Fox 64, but worse. Like, I don't know why Nintendo is so anti, hey, you gotta play the game the way we want to. Like, seriously, like... Oh, you just... Aw, dang it! I should, like, up down smash again! He would've died right there. Come on. Aw, dang it! He's grabbing the ledge a lot. That was free. Oh, so I'm gonna die right there. I'm just trying to get him off stage. I'm like, dude, stop doing that. But, yeah, like, Star Fox. Uh-oh. That was a weird recovery from, that. Now get off! But, yeah. He's not dead. Oh, he is dead! Okay! But... Oh, man. My story keeps getting messed up by my commentary. Next fight! Hey, guys! We got ourselves a Jigglypuff! But yeah, the point of my stories I'm trying to get along is that, like, Zero didn't interest me, and I can't buy Assault because Nintendo's being like, oh, you want a GameCube game? Well, guess you gotta pay 400 bucks for it, and I heard Adventure was bad, so I never picked it up. And gameplay-wise, Adventure kinda just looks like a Zelda game. Like, I don't play Star Fox for, like, Fox playing, like, Link? I play Star Fox because on-rail shooting and sci-fi stuff. Oh, so this Jigglypuff is being very aggressive. I should have, like, did anything with that. But I'm technically winning to that. Yeah, really good thing. If you're ever fighting a Jigglypuff, wait for them to hit and then, like, punish with anything. Well, not anything, but, like, you know, you see what I'm doing? Like, did Jigglypuff get to my face? Well, okay, I'm gonna hit you with something. Because Jigglypuff has a bit of lag after most moves. Like, she can throw out a lot of forward air, back air, tilts, up air, whatever. Still, she always flies into me. Like, if I was Little Mac right now, she'd be freaking screwed just because, like, I could just, like, super armor everything. I wish I was this decent Jigglypuff. Like, I can get people to 100, but then, like, I just die to something. Ah! Pfft. Okay. I don't know what happened there. I was shielding, but, okay, game. Oh, wow. Too free. Too bad it doesn't matter on Jigglypuff, because it's Jigglypuff! Yeah, he just keeps flying into me. Go ahead. But yeah, like, I hope we get more Star Fox games, because Star Fox is a series that definitely needs a, what would be the right word for it? It needs games that aren't just Star Fox 64. Oh god! This is scary. Oh god! Get away from me! Come on, get away! Get away! Oh, he almost died right there. Okay, and she's dead! There we go. Man. Yeah, that was a pretty good Jigglypuff. Though that back air was kind of bull if you ask me. Okay, we got a Game & Watch, so expect to see lots of down airs, like that. And bombs, like that. And fish, like that. okay. But luckily, I have a character with a really high jump. Ow! Ow! Stop blowing me up! Aw, if I could reach him. Man, he loves throwing that bomb. But, like, yeah, this kind of turned into a Star Fox kind of rant, where it's like, don't get me wrong, Star Fox is a good series. It's just that, like, the only games they seem to want to make for it are Star Fox 64 again. Like, they made Star Fox 2, so clearly it shows they can add stuff to the franchise, like the Chicken Walker. But, like, when it comes down to it, they don't seem to... Uh-oh, that's dead. Wah! They don't seem to want to do anything else. Like, why can't we get, like, a Star Fox 3, where it's basically the graphics of, like, I don't know, zero, I guess. But then, like, it's, you know, another galaxy, new planets. Let us play as other captains. Like, I was seriously hoping the Falco amiibo in Star Fox Zero would let you play as Falco. But no, it just gives you a black R-Wing where you take double damage, but you always have more power. Which is cool, but it's like, wouldn't it be better if, like, you could play as Falco in that? Instead, it's like, nope, you're just playing as Box, but it's basically hard mode. Wow, we're getting lots of damage in this game watch. Yeah, I'm not complaining. One interaction brought him to like 50. Oh, he almost died of that. Be careful, buddy. Your shield's really low. That's one of the negative things. You do not want a low shield in this game. Because lots of characters can kind of just kill you now. Okay, that was a lucky reflect. I just threw it out there because I was like, I wonder if it can hurt him. It blew him up. Like, he got killed. Ugh. Hey, look, an Indian. Even more Thanksgiving. I think of Star Fox, I'm on a Star Fox tangent. I saw concepts of, like, leaked Nintendo stuff, and one of them was, like, humans in the Star Fox world, which is interesting, because, like, you don't really get to see humans in Star Fox. I think that was, like, the first time I've seen a human in Star Fox style. Everyone's a furry. I mean, that's nice for me, because I just said I love Falco so much. Oh, be careful, buddy! I think he's a little scared. Oh, no! Look how happy he is. Funny, you're at, like, 95. That's not a good number. Buddy? Why did he shield so long? Well, he did. But, like, yeah. Sorry for the tangent. This is just, like, I like Star Fox, okay? But, like, it has a up and down game cycle. Wow, okay. We have Falco versus Falco. But clearly, he's probably the better Falco. Okay, so, word of advice. Here's some helpful things that will help you out when you fight a Falco. Just like I said earlier, you want to do that. And that. Like, Falco's up tilt, basically an anti-air point. Also, side B spikes. I wouldn't recommend going for it unless you're going towards the stage, because if you do that, Falco ain't coming back. Oh, okay. Sprout lasers, because it's a good damage dealer and it makes people come to you. Another helpful thing about Falco is that if you're fighting someone who kind of has like a... Uh-oh, that might be dead. Oh wow, he just went in to grab me. If this Falco has to up... Oh god! That's another thing. His down tilt's a kill move for some reason. But, like, look, he's off stage right now. Okay. Oh, dang it, I was too slow. If he has to up B, you can kind of just knock him out of it with a multi-hit or a spike. It's not that hard a time. Oh, I got my back air on him. Got him. Oh, I went for the off stage. You dead? Okay, he's dead. But, like, you kind of want to, like, kill this guy. Because Falco's one of those characters where it's, like, you can't really knock him off stage. You kind of have to kill him. Like, he has a high jump, and he has a decent recovery. So it's, like, it's either do or die. So, like, free grab. Neutral air. And now he's in the air, I can kind of just, like, hit him with aerials. Uh-oh, I might be dead. Oh god, I'm on my last duck. I gotta make a super comeback. Okay. Yep. Oh, okay. Aw, dang, I guess it could go behind me. Uh-oh. Ooh, I got the spike. Okay, get him off stage. Oh, I jammed him for a long time. Nice. Nice! Got the back air, and he got the spike. Be careful. I'm gonna kill him. Oh, God. Oh, God. I was really worried I was gonna pineapple there. Ah! See, look, he's trying to do it, too. Wait for it. There we go! That's how we end the Falco video. He died at like, what, 30? But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and I'm sorry for all the tangents. Have a nice Thanksgiving, and remember, like, subscribe, please get notified, and I'll see you guys next time for whenever I do another Smash video, okay? Bye!